happy to see all of you. Christine's asked me to talk about how do you decide what to measure for your project, which builds a little bit on the conversation I think folks have already had about qualitative analysis and data collection. So I want to present a simple framework which some of you know. This is actually non-obedience framework from quality improvement and patient safety. It's a way that I'm going to use to organize us around how would you decide what you might want to measure in your project. So I want to show you the framework, we'll go through the kinds of questions or situations you might be in, how you would approach asking and answering those questions, and then if you guys have further questions, we can take those at the end. If you're deciding what to measure for your project, there are three things that I think about, and then there's a bonus fourth category, which we'll come to at the end. If I'm in a situation where literature or a lot of smart people or collective experience suggests that we should build something because it is likely to make a difference. In other words, for example, we know that if you open somebody's coronary artery with a balloon, that blood flow returns to their heart, then it probably makes sense to have a place where you could deploy that technology. You don't have to have an RCT to start that research, right? You're going to need to create a cath lab to do that work. Literature experience suggests we should build this thing in order to do X, Y, or Z. Then it's helpful in the beginning to record or describe the components of the thing you want to build. This was exactly how we started actually cardiac cath research, was to say, this is the way you set up a cath lab, and this is the staffing requirement. And that's sufficient to move the literature forward because literature says we should probably build a place where we can deploy stents and balloons. Now, if it turns out that the literature says it's pretty clear that X leads to Y, building a cardiac cath lab actually decreases mortality, where we have studied that, then it's helpful to describe not the components of the cardiac cath lab, because we know that thing is already important. Rather, it's helpful to record and describe the steps of implementing that thing locally. So you will help advance the literature by sharing how did we take this idea, put it in place in our local environment, and describe the way that it got rolled out. Now, if rather you think the question is the literature doesn't clearly tell me that X leads to Y, then you're talking about trying to determine is there a relationship between the thing that you want to build or deploy and whether there's an impact that might be plausible. And that's where it makes sense to measure outcomes, the effect of doing X on people. So in this case, if it was not yet clear that building a cardiac cath lab actually impacted mortality, you might want to do that study and measure whether people lived or died, not simply describe how did we build and implement a cath lab at our particular place. So that's the overarching approach to deciding what you want to measure. Asking yourself, what does the literature tell me? What does experience tell me? And then what question am I trying to answer? I'm trying to determine if there's a relationship between X and Y. Think about measuring outcomes. Do I know there's a relationship between X and Y? And what I want to describe for people is how to take X and get Y here, process measures. It's pretty clear that if you build X, it's just a good idea, but it hasn't been done much. Let me describe the components of that thing I'm trying to build. Now, an important question often comes up. I look at that list and I have no idea. It's not clear what the literature says, or nothing is on this map. The thing I'm talking about, a resident dashboard, for example, has never actually been done, and there's no literature to suggest that it might be good. So if you find yourself having no idea, we have a couple of important options. Consulting expert, in this case, Christine Jones. To say, hey, help me think through, am I actually in one of these categories and I don't recognize it, or is this something that doesn't fit in one of these categories? The other way that we often explore this is to say, I'm not sure that X is going to make a difference. It's never been proven that X causes Y, and it's never been built anywhere. Is to then start with qualitative research. Asking questions to determine what some of the gaps might be, where this thing might make a difference, and whether it's relevant to the population that you want to study. So this is a place where you can decide you're moving to qualitative research and not quantitative research, which is measuring stuff, because you're going to get recognized you're not in one of those three categories. So that's part of the way I think about how am I going to decide what to measure. Questions that you guys have, either from your own projects, or if you want me to lay out other examples I've used in my own practice.